welcome back to DrummerConnection.com. Today we're going to take a look at one bar groups of seven. Now this is just expanding on one bar groups of three and one bar groups of five. So if you're not certain what's going on here, be sure you check out those lessons first. Okay? So like I said, we're just expanding. We're staying in 16th notes and we're just phrasing these patterns over one bar of 16th notes. Now when we did the threes, the sticking was right, left, left. When we went to the fives, we just added two notes and made those an additional right, left. So the fives were right, left, left. Doing the same thing today, adding two more notes to the sevens, and it's going to be right, left, right, left, right, left, left. Now remember, like I said, we're still phrasing this as 16th notes. So the first thing you want to do is check out one measure of 16th notes and see how many times this phrase of seven fits in. And as you can see, it fits two times. And at the end, there's two notes left over, and I just simply like to add a right and a left. So before we even take it to the kit and start to move it around and warm up with it, let's practice counting while we do the sticking. Very slow, like this, counting 16th notes. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one. Even slower. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one. So now let's move it to the snare drum and listen to it at a steady flow. Now once that's comfortable and you're getting used to those sevens going by, getting used to that sticking while we're counting 16th notes and always knowing where one is, we're going to start to practice accenting, like always, every single right hit within this pattern. But first, let's look at where these notes fall, give us a better heads up. The accents for the right hand are going to be the one and the and of beat one, the one and the of beat two, the e and the of beat three, and the end of beat four. One thing I like to do once you get used to hearing those sevens go by and make sure that you know where one is and you're counting those 16th notes, I just like to add the feet underneath. It's a great warm-up exercise and it really makes you commit to that quarter note pulse. So let's do quarter notes on the bass drum and every and or upbeat with the left foot. I think this is a great warm-up exercise, and I've spent many hours just messing with this and warming up around the kit. So let's do that. While we're warming up, let's just practice moving these single hits around to the toms. Hope you're enjoying one bar groups of seven. We're just getting into this concept, setting up some great warm-up exercises, gradually expanding around the kit. Don't worry, we got two bar groups of seven coming, and we're also going to post some lessons. We're going to show you guys how to apply this stuff around the drum set. Thanks.